What's up, people? You're watching CarTell TV, and I'm Jenny. The Kona has proved to be a pretty slick little SUV. It's aimed at the young and trendy and is packed with tech perks, particularly this Hyundai Kona Highlander that I'm reviewing here.
The Highlander is a top trim level, so it has the max in techy features. But to my slight dismay, this one is also equipped with a naturally aspirated 2-litre engine, which is the less cool option.
The other one is a 1.6-litre turbo. And from what I hear, Simone is going to be reviewing that in a few weeks.
Curse you, Simone!
On to the review. The small SUV is kind of quirky. Kind of like me, I guess.
It pretty much has to be, competing with the likes of the Nissan Juke, Toyota CHR, and Citroen C4 Cactus. I always find the name Cactus amusing.
The slim running lights look great, but they're pretty close to the ones on the Cactus.
Cactus. The grille is kind of high and large, and this weird connection between the lights and the cladding really draws attention.
Speaking of which, Hyundai call this cladding armor. A little over-glorified, maybe. Superhero complex much?
The wheels, they're 18 inches and also fit the top of the range feeling.
2 inches bigger than in the base trim level.
If I had to choose the best looking one in the market, the Toyota CHR might just get my vote. But the Kona has more than enough to get your attention.
As I already mentioned, I get the bigger, but less powerful engine.
It's a 2-litre inline 4. There is no forced induction on this one, but there is a 2-step variable induction that helps produce 110 kilowatts of power and 180 Nm of torque.
For both these figures, you need to go higher up in the rev range, as the top torque is available from 4,500 revs.
Well, I'm told this is far better in the 1.6-litre turbo, but more about that when someone else is reviewing it later.
Fuel consumption stands at 7.2 litres combined.
This engine is paired with a 6-speed transmission and comes with front-wheel drive configuration only.
Once you get behind the wheel, the lesser engine doesn't really feel underpowered.
Even though the top figures are found high up in the rev range.
There's enough grunt in the lower segments, so when you give the 2-litre engine some aggression, it responds quite happily.
If pushed hard, the engine shows its weaker heart. You can almost feel the strain. But when used around town, it is more than enough.
In terms of suspension, the Kona is tuned to our market, and the Hyundai engineers have proved themselves more than capable in this field consistently. Thanks, guys.
Once again, they've found a perfect mix of comfort and control. Mind you, this is a small SUV, so don't expect S-class comfort.
But in its segment, there aren't many better options in both comfort and dynamics.
On the inside, the Kona is small, but designed to enhance light and the feeling of spaciousness.
The interior design is less quirky, especially when comparing it to the CHR, but it's definitely not boring.
Ergonomics are great, and it all looks very tidy and well finished.
You get power windows all round, 4 cup holders, 4 bottle holders, and a leather-wrapped steering wheel and gear stick.
The front only gets one USB port, but there is a wireless charging pad. Ahead of the game, nice. The trim level under this one already introduces leather seats, climate control, and push button start.
What's reserved for this level only is heated steering wheel, heads up display, heated and cooled front seats, and wireless charging for your smartphone.
The touchscreen is pretty decent, with good old Apple CarPlay and Android Auto.
The boot gives 361 litres of space with the seats up, and an impressive 1,143 litres with the seats down.
Overall, the interior offers great perks, especially in this trim level.
It's practical, well-designed, and packed with features, so me gustan muchos.
There are a few gripes. It would be boring without a few.
First of all, some of the plastics are hard and feel kind of cheap. Sure, it's the case with many similar cars, but it does spoil the feeling. I just don't like this sound.
Secondly, the design is not the only thing that points to Kona being aimed at a younger or non-family market.
The rear seats aren't tiny, but they're not exactly business class, and there's no 12-volt, no USB, and no air vents, even in the top trim level. It's clear the Kona is not designed for sweaty passengers who need to charge things regularly.
Since I have the Highlander, safety is where this car really impresses. It's got 6 airbags, rear view camera, front and rear parking sensors, tire pressure monitoring, hill start assist and downhill brake control, traction control, blind spot monitoring, rear cross traffic alert, lane keeping assist, automatic emergency braking, pedestrian detection, driver attention and forward collision warning systems, cruise control, rain sensors, ABS, electronic brake force distribution, stability management and automatic high beams.
So what's the final verdict? Well, Hyundai definitely has another really awesome car on the market.
It also successfully gives the right perks to its target audience. This top-of-the-range 2-litre Highlander costs just over $37,000 on-road.
If you're young, trendy, techy, and you like small SUVs, well then the Kona in the Highlander trim may just be the one. There can be only one! Thanks for watching CarTell TV. Please subscribe to the channel and follow us on Instagram. We need more followers. I'd like to give a very special shout out to Brian Clements. He's our very first patron. And you too can become a patron. Just follow the link below. Have a great day.